Hello, my name is Babita. Today's topic is transformation. Transformation in a grammatical sense means changing sentences from one type to another. Now let's see, a sentence can be changed into following types. First, positive or affirmative. Second, negative. Third, interrogative. Fourth, interrogative, negative. Example is, she is a doctor is a positive or affirmative sentence. When we have to make negative, then we can use not. She is not a doctor. Then interrogative means to make a question. Is she a doctor? Then interrogative negative, is she not a doctor? So to use it, auxiliary verb and not, when we combine it, it becomes contraction. So we can use like this. Isn't she a doctor? Next, kinds of sentences. A sentence, before going to the kinds of sentences, let's see what's a sentence. A sentence is a group of words arranged in a specific order and which makes a complete sense. In English, we should arrange the sentence in subject, verb and object order. Let's see the example. Rises the sun in the east. Do you think it's a complete sentence? No, it's not a complete sentence because it's not arranged in a proper order. This specific arrangement is verb, subject plus object. Now let's see the proper arrangement of the object. As we have seen, group of words must be arranged in a proper order, then only it become a complete sentence. Like, the sun rises in the east is arranged in an order like subject and then verb and then object. So the sun rises in the east, it gives a complete sense. If we say only the sun rises, up to here it gives some sense, but it doesn't give a complete sense. But when we add the predicate in the east, so it gives a complete sense, so it is called sentence. Now let's see different kinds of sentences, and they are assertive or declarative sentence. Sometimes students are confused between the assertive and affirmative. They are just confused what is assertive and what is affirmative. Affirmative sentence is those sentences which are only positive. Affirmative sentence means only positive sentence which contains a positive sense. But assertive sentence contain all kind of declarative sentence, either it is positive or negative. Second is interrogative sentence. And third is imperative sentence. Fourth is exclamatory sentence. And fifth is optative sentence. Now, let us see one by one and its example. First is assertive or declarative sentence. Sentences which make simple assertion or statements of fact are called assertive or declarative sentence. I repeat, assertive or declarative sentence is such sentence which just make a statement of fact. Now let's see through some examples. Let's see examples of assertive sentences like, it is raining. So it is raining, it gives just the statement of fact. The child is going to school, which means is also telling the fact that the child is going to school. I get up early in the morning. I like reading. So these all statements show the facts. Facts, or it's a declaration which is happening. So therefore it is called assertive or declarative sentence. And as I have talked about just now, like affirmative sentence, some students are confused in assertive and affirmative. That is, sentences which give a positive sense, those sentences are only affirmative. Like, honesty is the best policy. Barking dogs seldom bite. I have been to Pokhara. So these all statements give a positive sense. Therefore, it is a affirmative sentence. Now, we are going to see the next kind of sentence, that is interrogative sentence. Let's see some examples of interrogative sentence which asks questions. The sentences which ask questions are called interrogative sentences. For example, what is your name? Where do you live? Who is your father? Can you solve this problem? The sentence which expresses all kinds of questions are called interrogative sentence. Next example is imperative sentence. Imperative sentences contain orders, commands, requests, advice, proposals or suggestions. These sentences are called imperative sentence. I repeat, sentences which express orders, commands, request, advice, proposals or suggestions are called imperative sentence. Now let's see some examples of imperative sentence. First one is leave this place at once. So what do you think? This is order, request or advice? This is order. It sounds like an order. Leave this place at once. Get lost. So this also express an order. And now, please help me. This is what? It express a request. Now, work hard. What kind of sentence this sounds? It is imperative, but what kind of sense it sounds? Work hard, it is an advice. Let's go for a walk. It is a sense of suggestion. So the sentence which contains an order, request, advice, suggestion is called an imperative sentence, as we have seen the definition. Imperative sentence. Now next sentence we can see is exclamatory sentences. Sentences which express some strong feelings or emotions such as joy, sorrow, regret, surprise, wonder, etc. are called exclamatory sentences. Once again, sentences which express some strong feelings or emotions such as joy, sorrow, regret, surprise, wonder, etc. are called exclamatory sentences. Now examples, what a beautiful day. So it is denoted by always exclamatory mark. This is exclamatory mark. What a beautiful day. How beautiful the flower is. Hurrah, we have won. Hurrah, exclamatory mark, we have won. Means this is a expression of joy. Alas, she is no more. This is an expression of sorrow. Alas, she is no more. So now the next example we can see is optative sentence. Now let's see the fifth sentence, optative sentence. Optative sentences which express an ardent wish, prayer, curse, etc. are called optative sentences. Sentences which express an ardent wish, prayer, curse, etc. are called optative sentence. For example, may you live long. Again, you have to remember exclamatory mark here. May God help you, exclamatory mark here. So these are called the optative sentence because it contains wish. Not only wish, prayer also, and sometimes curse also. So therefore it is an optative sentence. So in the part 1 we have seen 5 types of sentences, that is assertive or declarative sentence, interrogative sentence, an imperative sentence, exclamatory sentence and optative sentence. So this was all the 5 types of sentences. It was introduced and explained with some examples. Now in part 2, we are going to see the transformation of sentences into another type of sentences. So we can transform sentence in this part 2. Transform affirmative and negative sentences interchangeably, and transform interrogative and assertive sentence interchangeably, and exclamatory and assertive sentences interchangeably. Interchangeably, it means making affirmative sentence into negative and negative sentence into affirmative. Similarly, interrogative sentences into assertive and assertive sentence into interrogative. Exclamatory into assertive and assertive into exclamatory. Sentence can be transformed into different kinds of sentences without changing its meaning of the sentence. So this transformation we have to see in this transformation. Sentences can be transformed into another types of sentences without changing its meaning. So that is called transformation, and we can see by some examples. Everyone loves dreaming, that is affirmative, but no one hates dreaming, that is negative. The meaning is same. Without changing the meaning, the same thing has been expressed in a two way, that is affirmative and in a negative sentence, like no one. So no one is used here. Everyone loves dreaming, no one hates dreaming, which means the same. Now let's see the structure of affirmative sentence and negative sentence. In a negative sentences containing the verb to be means, here we can see is, am, are, were. The verb is followed by the word not or the an apostrophe t. Now let's see some examples. Shreya is not in her room. So is to be verb here. Is to be verb here, as just now I have said, is, am, are, were. The negative not is also used with the verb has, have, and had. So we can also use the not word. This is a negative word not, which is also used with the has and have. Now let's see some more examples. He hasn't got the tickets. So we can use not is placed between the has auxiliary verb and got the main verb. So not is placed between the auxiliary verb and main verb to make it negative. She will not wait for me. Again here will auxiliary verb and main verb wait and not is used or placed between these two, so that it becomes a negative sentence. She will not wait for me. We can see some more examples. Let's do some examples of affirmative and negative interchangeably. First, let's convert affirmative sentence into negative sentences. Now let's read the first sentences. Ramu is eating an apple. So how can we change it into negative? Ramu is eating an apple. Is an auxiliary verb. So here we can write Ramu is not eating an apple. In the previous example, as I have said, not in negative word will be put between the auxiliary verb and main verb. Auxiliary verb and main verb. So Ramu is not eating an apple is a negative verb. Negative sentence. He has come home late. He has not come home late. So again, after the auxiliary verb and the main verb, the position of not is after the auxiliary verb and main verb come. So he has not come home late. So this is again a negative sentence. Let's convert the third sentence. She will have finished her work. So here, she will not have finished her work. Now again, she will not have finished her work. So this is the negative sentence. They can pass the exam. They cannot pass the exam. So now you have seen the changing of affirmative sentences into negative sentences using the not between the auxiliary verb and main verb. So now we are going to see the sentences, negative sentences changing into affirmative sentences. The first one is, he does not go for a walk every day. So how can we make it affirmative? Can we make like, he does go for a walk every day? Let's try it first. He does go for a walk every day. So do you think this is a correct form of sentence? No, this is not a correct form of sentence. He does not go for a walk every day is a negative, but its affirmative will be, he goes for a walk every day. So we don't have to put does while making it affirmative. So this will be wrong. So what we can do is, he goes for a walk every day. He goes for a walk every day. But when we make it negative, we introduce do, does, or did. So now let's make the other one. The other one, they do not play football. They play football. So this is an affirmative, which means positive. They play football. Now third, he did not come to me yesterday. So the third one will be, came to me yesterday. As I have said, very often students are confused when they are told to make the sentence affirmative. They use this auxiliary verb do, did not. So it is not correct. So he did not come to me yesterday. He came to me yesterday. We use do, did, does according to its subject when we make it negative. Now let's see the other transformation. Let's do some more examples of changing the sentences into interrogative sentences into assertive sentence. For that, you have to keep in mind the verb. Is Ram eating an apple? So what will be the assertive or affirmative sentence? That is, Ram is eating an apple. It is just simply a removal of auxiliary verb from this sentence and it becomes an assertive sentence. Ram is eating an apple. I'm so sorry, I have said removal. Instead of the first is put before Ram, so now it will come here. Ram is eating an apple. Has he come home late? So again, he has come home late. This make a statement affirmative or assertive. He has come home late. Next, will he make the roof? He will make the roof. He will make the room. Will she have finished her work? She will have finished her work. So, in interrogative sentence, we just put the question, the auxiliary verb first to make a question, interrogative, right? So, these are the examples of converting interrogative into assertive, like, is Ram eating an apple? Ram is eating an apple. So, here, all these verbs, these are all auxiliary verb. Ram is eating an apple. He has come home late. He will make the roof. She will have. She will have finished her work. So these were the conversion of sentences from interrogative to assertive. Now, one more is left. Will they visit the park tomorrow? They will visit a park tomorrow. Now, affirmative sentence has to be changed in interrogative sentence. For that, how we can do? We play golf. Now we have to introduce do. We play golf. To make it interrogative, we can introduce do because it's an auxiliary verb. Do we play golf? And question mark. He played golf. Now the tense is past V2, so we will use did he play golf. He plays golf. Now he is a third person singular. So he is a third person singular. May I write for you here? Third person singular. So which contains S or ES. So he plays golf. So here we have to make question. Does he play golf? And question mark. So this for the conversion or affirmative sentences into interrogative sentences. Now we can see some more conversion, that is exclamatory to assertive sentence. Let's do some examples of exclamatory sentence and then assertive sentence. You have to change exclamatory sentence into assertive sentence. You have seen in this sentence, all sentences are containing exclamatory mark. Exclamatory sentence must be denoted with exclamatory mark, while assertive sentence must be denoted with full stop. Now let's change this sentence. What a beautiful flower. When we express with sudden feeling, strong feeling, exclamatory mark, that expression comes, what a beautiful flower. So when we change into assertive, it becomes very simple, just a statement of fact. So it is a beautiful flower. We can place it, that word with it. What a great victory. It is a great victory. It is just a simple sentence which expresses fact. What a glorious morning. It is a glorious morning. It is also just a statement of fact, or you can also add, it is indeed a glorious morning. Now the last one, alas, she is no more. This is an expression of sorrow, so we can simply just write in assertive, she is no more. it expresses again the statement of fact, and we can use the full stop at last. So dear students, we have so far we have studied these things. So let's recapitulate the following things we have studied just now. Today we have seen what is a sentence first, and then kind of sentences. And in what is a sentence, we have seen that sentence is a group of words which makes complete sense, but it has to be arranged in a specific order, like subject, verb, object. And then in kinds of sentences, we have seen 5 types of sentences: assertive, declarative, and affirmative sentence. As I have said, students are very often confused in affirmative and assertive. What is the difference between assertive and affirmative? Assertive sentence can be negative and positive, but it is just the statement of fact, while affirmative sentence is only positive sentence. Next is interrogative sentence. It asks questions. And third is imperative sentence, which contains order and request. An exclamatory sentence is which expresses sudden feeling of joy, happiness, and sorrow. An optative sentence is the last sentence. It expresses wish, prayer, and curse. Optative sentence which expresses wish, prayer, and curse. So, these sentences are denoted with the mark, like assertive, declarative, and affirmative sentence is denoted with the full stop. We have to give full stop. For interrogative, question mark, and for imperative, we also give full stop here. And then exclamatory sentences, we give exclamatory mark, and for optative also we give the exclamatory mark. So in the part 1 we have seen the kinds of sentences with the definition of a sentence. Now in part 2 we have seen transformation of sentences, transformation of kinds of sentences, because sentence can be transformed in various types of sentences without changing its meaning. So we have seen 3 important things: affirmative to negative, interrogative to assertive, and exclamatory to affirmative, interchangeably in the sense affirmative to negative, negative to affirmative, interrogative to assertive, assertive to interrogative, and exclamatory to affirmative, and affirmative to exclamatory. And we have seen when there is a verb, to be verb contains is, am, are, were. So whenever this kind of verbs, to be verb is there, then we have used the not, the negative verb not, between the auxiliary verb and main verb to make the sentence negative. Let's see some more about positive, negative, and interrogative sentences. In positive, when something is given there, it changes into nothing, and in interrogative, it changes into anything. Now let's see some examples. Positive: he has something in his pocket. He has nothing in his pocket. Something changes into nothing. And in interrogative, has he anything in his pocket? We cannot say has he something in his pocket or has he nothing in his pocket, but something changes into nothing in negative, and it changes again into anything. Has he anything in his pocket? So this is interrogative. Next example shows again: she always plays hockey. She never plays hockey. Always changes into never. Then does she ever? Then never changes into ever. Actually, does she ever play hockey? So this shows the conversion. Always should change into never and then ever. Now the another example: they have seen her somewhere. They have not seen her anywhere. Somewhere changes into anywhere. Have they seen her anywhere? But here it remains the same. Have they seen her anywhere? Now next example is: somebody will come to meet you. Negative. Negative will be nobody. Here is somebody. Negative. Nobody will come to meet you. In interrogative sentence, will anybody come to meet you? So here we can see somebody in the positive sentence, in the negative sentence nobody, and in the third interrogative sentence anybody come to meet you. So these are the changes, and I'm going to give you a list of words which has to be changed into positive and negative. Okay, so following are the changes. When you have to convert positive changes into negative, there are some words which you have to keep in mind, because those words are just converted into another words. This conversion is very important. Let us see. Already changes into yet, something changes into nothing, any of, none of, two changes into either, sometime, seldom, as, dot dot, as, not so, always changes into never, a lot of changes into many or much, someone changes into no one, and somebody changes into nobody, some changes into any, ever changes into never, several changes into any, a few changes into any, and so changes into and neither, somewhere changes into anywhere, still changes into any longer. This is a table. This table is very important. Keep in mind. Now we have following examples on this another table. Now let's see. This is an affirmative, and this side negative and interrogative sentences. He reads several books. He reads several books. Several changes into any. Here, does she read any books? When the affirmative sentence has to be changed into negative, he does not read any book instead of several books. Then does she read any books? Any remains the same. In interrogative sentence. Next example, he has bought some dresses. He has not bought any dresses. You have seen. So some changes into any. And in this table also, we have seen that in the 11th number, some changes into any. So she has already visited Pokhara, and its negative is she has not visited Pokhara yet. So, and its interrogative form is, has she not visited Pokhara yet? So, and you have seen again in this table, it is already given here, already will change this into here. So keep in mind, you have to learn this. Next, he has collected a lot of stamps, and a lot will change again. A lot of will change into many or much. Now let's see in this example, we'll clarify more. He has not collected many stamps. Instead of a lot of, there is many stamps. Then the question is the interrogative. Has he collected many stamps? And then, there is a lot of sugar in the tea. Again, as it was given in the table, a lot of, many or much. Many we had already used, now we are using much. There is not much sugar in the tea. Much instead of a lot of. Is there much sugar in the tea instead of a lot of? So, generally, the word remains the same in interrogative. Sometimes or rarely it changes. Now let's see some more examples. Example number 7. She always visits the park. She always visits the park. Now, changing it into negative sentence, always will become never. She never visits the park. And does she ever visit the park? You might have noticed always, never, and ever. When you ask the question in interrogative sentence, it becomes ever. Does she ever visit the park? And here the question mark. Next is, he must wear a uniform. So changing it into negative, So must will become need not. He need not wear a uniform when there is no necessity. Means it is okay if he doesn't wear even a uniform. But in the another condition, first the question of this is, must he wear a uniform? So must itself will be used for interrogative. And another example, substitution of must is, he must not drink alcohol. When the things come of prohibition, when he must not do, then the must not will exactly appear there with the negation not. He must not drink alcohol. So in this table, we have seen all those words like always and but only must is not available in this table. Otherwise, all others are there. Now, the ninth example, somebody stole her pen. Somebody will change into nobody. Nobody stole her pen. And then in the question, did anybody steal her pen? Very often students make a mistake. Did anybody stole her pen? So here they used to put stole. So two past verb cannot come together in a same sentence. So you will use here verb one. So did anybody steal her pen? Now the next example is, they like meat too. And you have seen what the two should be changed into? Two should be changed into either. Okay, so here we can find in this table, you can see very clearly, they like meat too. Two after comma at the end. They do not like meat either. So two will substituted by the either. Then next is either or. Either he or she will do it. Neither he nor she will do it. It means either or change will, neither nor. So you can find all these words which has to be substituted. While you will use in negative or you will make interrogative sentence, you find in this table. Let's do some more examples. Choose and copy the best answers. Choose and copy the best answers. Now let's see. The negative of my dog loves traveling in fast cars. Now let's see the sentence very clearly. My dog loves traveling in fast cars. Is the negative of this sentence is, my dog does dot dash in fast cars. So what will be the appropriate answer? You have to choose. Like, my dog does dash in fast cars. Love traveling, it may not be suitable. My dog does love traveling, no. Not loves traveling, my dog does not love traveling, it doesn't also see it is also not suitable. So not love traveling. So this is the correct answer. My dog does not love traveling. So this is the correct answer you have chosen. Now the two number, A dash out question mark, B. He never goes out. For this answer, you have to choose the question, means from this, which one is the appropriate one. He never goes out. Mark the word never. So, does he go? Does he sometimes go? Goes? Does he ever go? So the appropriate answer is, does he ever go? Does he ever go out? So now, third, the question for the answer, I am a gardener, is what dash? Do you? What do you? So, do you think this is an appropriate question to ask? For the answer, I am a gardener. What do you? What do you do? What you are? So, the appropriate answer must be, what do you do? What do you do? Now, fourth, he likes nothing. It also means he dash dash not like anything, does not like anything, does not like nothing. So, what will be the appropriate answer you think? Mark the word again, nothing. He likes nothing. It also means he not like anything. So two, anything is here also, anything given here also, and it is given here also. So the appropriate answer must be, he does not like anything. Does not like, he does not like anything. He likes nothing. It also means he doesn't like anything. This one. Next, fifth number. She gave me a book. The correct what question of the statement is dash. What did she give you? What did she give you? This one. Or what did she give you? Please mark the word. This also V2 and this also V2. This is an inappropriate. Sometimes students use V2 with did also. But you don't have to use this. Then, what did she give a book? It doesn't make much sense. What did she give a book? The question itself has answer. So, she gave me a book. The correct what question of the statement is, what did she give you? The correct answer is, what did she give you? What did she give you? Let's see the example number 6. The negative transformation of the sentence, you did it nicely, is you dash it nicely. The examples, the options given are didn't do, don't do, doesn't it. So, which you think is an appropriate? You did it nicely is you negative didn't do it nicely. The appropriate is you didn't do it nicely. So this one is the appropriate. Now example number 7. Sushma did it. We have to change this Sushma did it into negative form. And for that, Sushma did not do it is the appropriate answer. So Sushma did not do it is the negative of Sushma did it. The affirmative of don't put any milk in your tea. As in the previous table I have told you to mark the word like any. Now let's see. The affirmative of don't put any milk in your tea is put any milk in your tea. No, this one is not appropriate. Do put any milk in your tea. This also does not look appropriate. So, put some milk in your tea. Yes. So, any is given here and the right conversion here is some milk. Put some milk in your tea. Put some milk in your tea. So, the affirmative of the negative sentence don't put any milk in your tea is put some milk in your tea. So, this is the example. So, In this way, we can do the transformation of sentences, marking some important keywords. Thank you. Hello, my name is Babita. Welcome to today's English lesson, question tags. We use question tags very often in our day-to-day life. It's interesting but a little bit confusing. Let's see. Question tags are used to confirm that something is true or not, and to encourage a reply from the person we are speaking to. Question tags are very short questions at the end of the statements. So its purpose is to confirm that something is true or not. You are not sure about it. And the second purpose is to encourage a reply from the person we are speaking to. So you want to carry on conversation with that person. So you would like to use a tag. Intonation in question tag. The second point in question tag is very important, that is intonation in question tag. This example will clarify you. It is a nice day today, isn't it? This is a rising tone. I have shown this arrow. This is a rising tone. So, it is a nice day today, isn't it? So, my pitch is rising. So, tone, rising tone. It shows that, the rising tone shows that you are sure or not. But, it is a nice day today, isn't it? So, this is a falling tone. The second one, it is a nice day today, isn't it? It's a falling tone, while the upper one, it is a nice day today, isn't it? So, you use rising tone in the tag to show whether you yourself is not sure. And the second is you just want a reply from that person to carry on the conversation. Next we can see question tags are mostly and always formed with the auxiliary verb. Auxiliary or modal verb. So question tags are always formed with the auxiliary or modal verb. We can see with some examples. Kalpana can speak English. This is a tag. Can she? And this is the auxiliary verb. And here we have made the tag with the auxiliary verb can. And because we are going to see a negative statement is followed by a positive question tag. It's very important. If a statement is a negative, then tag will be a positive. And the example is, they aren't funny. So this is an example. This is a negative statement and tag is positive. He shouldn't say things like that. Should he? So, here in the tag, the statement is negative, the tag is positive. Here also statement is negative, the tag is positive. So, a positive statement is followed by a negative question. So, vice versa. When a statement is positive, the tag will be negative. Let's see through this example. Naveen is from Gorkha. So, is here to be verb. Naveen is from Gorkha, isn't he? This is a negative. Isn't he? So we are confirming. They are coming today. Again are. Aren't they? So, now it should be very clear to you that when the statement is positive, the tag is negative. And when the statement is negative, the tag is positive. So, now let's see the next point. Present simple form verbs contain do and does in the question tag. Like, you play the guitar. This is a statement of the simple present tense. So therefore, we are using don't you. You play the guitar. So do is introduced in the tag. You play the guitar, don't you? Now Allison likes. Allison here, third person singular. Third person singular, and likes is S verb. So Allison likes tennis, doesn't she? So doesn't she is introduced as a question tag. So all present simple tense, present simple form verbs take do and does in a question tag. Similarly, let's talk about the past simple. Here is a past simple. Past simple you simply did in a question tag. Now let's see the example. They went to the cinema. Here the past verb is went. They went to cinema. And we have to make the tag with did. So didn't they? Since it's a positive, the tag is negative. Didn't they? The other is she studied in New Zealand. So again the past verb V2 is used here. So the tag will also be the negative. Past verb positive is used here. She studied in New Zealand. So the tag will be didn't she? Negative tag. Now let's see the next rules of this, general rules of this question tag, that is word which gives negative meaning. Very often students are not familiar with the words like hardly, rarely, scarcely, seldom, ever, neither, and etc. There may be some more words which I couldn't write here. So these words always give negative meaning. When students are not sure either it is positive or negative, they are not able to make the tag appropriately. Now let's see. He hardly ever speaks. So hardly means negative. So it's a negative word. So the tag is positive. Does he? He hardly ever speaks. Does he? Now, they rarely eat in restaurants. Again, this rarely word shows the negative sense. So the tag is positive. Do they? They rarely eat in restaurants. Do they? Now, the other important point is modal verbs in the statement. Whenever there is modal verb in the statement and the tag will be made up of with the same auxiliary verb or same modal verb. Now let's see. You should get up early. We must. So these are modal verb. Whenever the statement is made up of modal verb, and then the tag will also be used with the same modal verb. You should get up early, shouldn't you? We must help them, mustn't we? So these are the examples. The other important point is we very often have seen apostrophe S is equal to is or has. How will you decide that apostrophe used is or has? How will you recognize that? That is the point. I'll just show you how it can be. She is in the office. So how will you recognize whether she is in the office? And you can put the tag isn't she. You very often read in the grammar book. But how do you know that isn't she answer is correct? Because the sentence you can see, she is in the office, is the simple present form. The is the to be verb form. So that's why you have decided that this is the simple present form and the tag will be isn't she. Next, this example, I missed the first one. Peter's got a car and your tag is hasn't he? Then again, here you have put apostrophe S, isn't she, isn't, and here apostrophe S is there, you have put hasn't. How come this happened? So you can decide it with the verb used here. This will help you to recognize the proper tense, that is got. So that get, got. Peter has got a car, hasn't he? So it decide the tense we can know through this keyword. Peter has got a car, hasn't he? Next important point, we are coming to the have and do. Have and do are often both possible after the noun auxiliary have. Let's see some more examples. Let's see further. Have as a main verb. Whenever there is a have as a main verb, then we mostly use do, does, did. Now, according to the form of have. Now, let's see. Mr. Sharma has two cars. Can you see any other verb other than has? No. You can see only one verb, that is has. So there is no other verb than has, so it is a main verb. When has, have, had is used as a main verb, then our tag takes the form of do, doesn't, did. Now, so Mr. Sharma has two cars, doesn't he? They have a garden, don't they? But there is an exceptional case, always it used to be there. Do is preferred in American English, but. So very often this has also used in tag. Like Mr. Sharma has two cars, hasn't he? Why not hasn't he? And they have a garden, haven't they? Why not haven't they? So both are in use, but American English prefer do in this tag, even though there is has, have or had. Now, another point, no, no one, nothing, nobody gives negative sense. Therefore, nothing will cure his illness. So, the will it, nothing will cure his illness. It's a negative sense, will it? The tag is positive. He never acts like a gentleman, does he? So never gives a negative sense, so the tag is positive, does he? I have no idea, do I? So no here also give a negative sense, so the tag is positive. Next point, somebody, anybody, nobody, everybody, no one and neither, etc. There are so many such examples. We use pronoun they whenever the subject is there, like this somebody, nobody and everybody as a subject, then we use they in a tag. Let's see example. Somebody entered the garden, so the tag is didn't they, used as a pronoun. Earlier we used to use the pronoun which is given. If the name noun is given, we use the pronoun like he or she. But when there is not given, so we use didn't they instead of somebody, nobody, anybody, everybody. Everybody was upset. Here again, everybody was upset. Weren't they? So they is used as a pronoun here. Nobody objects to the plan. Do they? The positive, because it is a negative sense. Next point is, when the subject of the statement is that or this, the pronoun you have to use in the tag is it. Very confusing? You don't have to, because grammar has several rules and you just have to follow the rules. Then there will be no confusion at all. So, on the one hand, it says that whenever there is a subject like somebody, nobody, everybody, then you have to use pronoun they. But in this case, whenever you have the subject like this and that, then you have to use the pronoun like it. Whenever the subject is that or this, you have to use the pronoun it. Now let's see the example. This is an expensive necklace. This as a subject. So isn't to be verb again? Isn't it instead of this? Isn't this very awkward to say? So isn't it? That wasn't a big surprise. Was it negative statement, positive tag? I hope it's clear to you. Now moving on to the next point, these and those. Again, these and those as a subject. So whenever there is a change of subject, there is a change of pronoun. Then you will use the pronoun at last they in a tag. Like those are very naughty children. Now let's see those here as a subject. Those are very naughty children, aren't they? For those, it is replaced by they pronoun. And these, again subject, these weren't yours, were they? The positive tag because the negative statement. So up to here is clear. I just would like to repeat once again. When there is a subject like nothing, then you will use it, nothing. Then you will use the pronoun like it. And whenever there is body, somebody, nobody, anybody, and then you will use the pronoun like they. And then when there is a subject like this and that, then you will use it. And for these and those, you will use they. So these are just simply a grammar rule. Next, we are moving to the next point, there plus be combination. Whenever the subject contains there, as we have seen the various subjects in the statement, then again the pronoun will be there itself. Like there plus be combination, to be verb, and there. Example will clarify. There isn't a hotel next to the museum. There here as a subject. There isn't a hotel next to the museum. Is there? Because you have seen that the rule says that for there you have to use the pronoun there. Here again the next example subject is there. There won't be any trouble. Will there? So you have seen that there is used as a pronoun. Next point is let's has the tag shall we. Very often we have used this phrase let's, like let's have a party, shall we? Let's go out for a walk, shall we? But let us go out, will you? Why this difference? This is a small difference, but sometimes we are not familiar with this. Let's have a party. Here also apostrophe s, let's. Here also apostrophe s, let's. But here it is, it's not apostrophe, it's without apostrophe, let us. So these two statements, first two these statements are suggestion. Therefore, it has a tag shall we, because it's a suggestion. But let us go out, it's a kind of imperative. It's an imperative. It doesn't sound like suggestion. So therefore, imperative sentence, the general rule says that for imperative sentence, we have to use the tag will you. Let us go out, will you? Let us go out for a walk, shall we? So it's more polite suggestion. Now, introductory phrases. These are the introductory phrases like I am afraid, I think, I believe, I am sure, I suspect, I suppose, it appears that, it seems that. These are the phrases, and such phrases can be more. Don't affect question tags except for the transfer of negation. When we have to understand the proper statement, whether it is a negative or positive. Let's see some more examples. Let's see some examples. For introductory phrases like I'm afraid, I think, I believe, I suppose, I hope, as far as I can see. So this type of sentences takes the same question tags except for the transfer of negation. Let's see some examples. I suppose you are not serious. The tag is are you, as usual according to the tense. I think my mom returned home. Didn't she? According to the tense. Past tense is given, so the tag is didn't she. I don't suppose you are serious. Are you? It appears that she is enjoying herself. Isn't she? So, the tag is usually we can put as the general rules. We just have to understand the transfer of negation. Next point is I am. So, whenever there is a am structure, I am in the statement, then we use the aren't or are in the tag. Example, I am your father, aren't I? Why not am and I? Is very unusual as per the rule of grammar. I am a bit late, aren't I? I am a teacher, aren't I? So you can see all the structure of am is given, am. I am, but here, aren't I, and aren't I. So, the tag is substituted with aren't I instead of am. Am is bit unusual, we hardly hear such kind of tag. Now, negative interrogative question tag. This is also very unusual. It is just I would like to share with you. You lied to him. Generally, we say, didn't you? But here, did you not? So, have you ever heard like this? So, it is just a much less usual form. But let's focus on the recapitulation of the point we have learned. We have seen that in this chapter, we have learned some general rules for the question tag for the statement. Statement, if it is positive, the tag will be negative. And if the statement is negative, the tag will be positive. So, this is a rule. And if the tag, if the person asks and if you use the question tag in a statement, if it is in rising tone, it means the person want to make sure about it. And if it is in a falling tone for it, he wants to carry on the conversation because he is interested to talk to you. For example, it's a nice day, isn't it? So this is a rising tone, it means he's not sure, but falling tone, it's a nice day, isn't it? It just want to carry on the conversation. Auxiliary verb is used for a tag. Mostly we have seen that question tags are made up of using the auxiliary verb, not the main verb. Hardly, rarely, scarcely, this kind of words always give a negative sense. So if the statement contains such words, it means that is a negative statement. Somebody, anybody, we have just used, they used as a pronoun in a tag. Whenever there is a somebody, anybody, nobody, then they is used as a pronoun in a tag. And this is that the pronoun in the tag will be it. And these and those, the pronoun will be again they. And as I said, if I am in the tag, am, and then the tag will be used with are. Next, but not the least, everything, nothing, anything is also substituted with the pronoun it in the question tag. So, example is everything is ready, isn't it? Thank you. So, dear students, let's do some examples. It's written on the board. Now, choose the correct alternative. He is very lazy, full stop. He always dash his mother to clean his room. So, what appropriate answer you can choose and fill here? So, let's share. He is very lazy. He always dash his mother. So, he is a subject here and his mother is agent. So, what do you think? He always dash his mother to clean his room. So, two infinitive is here. to infinity. And the option given is make, makes, gets. And the proper option is gets. He always gets his mother, agent, doer of the action, to clean his room. Now, next example. The teacher made the students. So, the causative verb here is made. Here, causative verb. The students again, agent. Dash the exercise. And the option given is do, to do, and done. Whenever there is agent with made, causative verb made, so the verb one will fit there. So do. The teacher made the students do the exercise. So this is do is the correct option. Next, third example. The engineer, subject, got is causative verb, and the workman, again agent. And according to the structure, we have seen that whenever there is an agent with got, then there will be two infinitive. So the answer is to build. We made the gardener dash the grass. So we subject, made causative verb, the gardener again agent. And whenever there is agent with made, and there will be a first form. So Rita got her dress. Now we can see got is causative verb and her dress here is object. So Rita got her dress, object. Whenever there is object, we must put V3, washed, to wash, washed. So V3 is here. So this is the correct answer, washed. Next, my daughter, subject, made causative verb, me, agent. My daughter made me dash an expensive sari for her. So, made agent, so there will be verb one. So, verb one will be the suitable answer, and that is buy. Next example, Ram had a pen. Ram subject, had causative verb, a pen object. So Ram had a pen. Whenever there is a object with had, so there will be V3. So the answer is bought. Ram had a pen bought yesterday. Meena dash Sambhu to carry her suitcase. We very clearly see two infinitive is here. Two infinitive is here, and it always suits with the get form. Meena dash Sambhu to carry her suitcase. But here, according to the tense, got is given. So Meena got Sambhu to carry her suit. As I said, suitcase. So as I've said, get is used in the condition of to convince something. Kumari dash her brother, subject. So causative verb we have to find out here. Her brother is agent. Turn on the TV, V1. So subject is here, agent is here, verb one is here, and in the bracket get, make, has. Which one is suit? Get, no way. Then make, yes, because it's about the compulsion. Kumari make her brother turn on the TV. So, last example, 10th, Barsha got new book. Barsha, subject got causative verb, new book object. Subject, causative verb in the past, yes, and new book is object. So whenever there is object with get or got, so there will be V3. B-O-U-G-S-T, bought. And Barsha got new books, bought. So these are the 10 examples we have rightly completed. I hope your answers is exactly what I have written on the board. Thank you.